So you've got your two blocks. If you've got two blocks, if not just one block, lie down onto your back. Stretch your legs out into Shavasana and just take a moment to bring our mind and body into the practice. After a long weekend of being off, taking a nice deep breath in through the nose and take a breath out through the mouth. And as you do that, allow the body to settle into the ground. Relax from the crown of the head through the shoulders, the chest, the hips, the legs and the feet. And bring in a little bit more focus to the breath, taking a deep breath in through the nose and a big lazy breath out through the mouth. Deep breath in through the nose and a big lazy breath out through the mouth. One more deep breath in and a big breath out. On the next inhale, sweep the arms up above you, bring the feet together, long stretch. And then as you breathe out, bring the arms up and over, knees into the chest, and little rock from side to side. Good. Perfect. Just easing into that lower back. Little rock, just nice and slowly. And then coming to centre. Take an inhale and then exhale both feet to the floor, keeping the knees bent. And on the next inhale, extend that right leg up to the sky, interlace your hands behind your right hamstring, lengthening up through that right leg. Hips are heavy, dropping down into the floor. Heel reaches up to the sky. If you want to, you can move the toes. Inhale, lift them up. Exhale, drop them down, just nice and slow. From getting into the ankles a little bit. Perfect. And then maybe rotating the toes around one way, big circles with the toes. And then change directions, take the toes the other way. And then come to centre, allow the hips to be heavy, reach up into the heel, then drop the toes down towards your forehead. Take an inhale and exhale, bend the right knee, place that foot back to the floor. Inhale, stretch the left leg up to the sky, interlace the hands behind your left hamstring. Allow the hips to be heavy, reach the heel up to the sky, and drop the toes down towards your forehead. And then from here, if you want to move the toes up and down, breathe the toes up to the ceiling, inhale, and then exhale, drop the toes down towards your forehead. Just a few times, nice and slowly. Maybe get a bit of cracking with the ankles and the joints, which is okay. And then rotating the foot going around one way, so drawing big circles with the big toe. And then go the other way, reverse direction. Come back to center, take an inhale. Exhale, lengthen through the back of that leg, reaching that heel up to the sky. Take a breath in, and then when you breathe out, bend that left knee, place that left foot back to the floor. Coming into a quad stretch, grab hold of your right foot with your left hand, underneath your bottom, and then drop that knee to the floor, extend it to the front of the mat. Take that right arm up and over behind you, back of the hand drops to the floor, and then lengthen that left leg along the floor. Reaching into your fingertips, reaching all the way down into your left toes. And if you can't feel that stretch in your quad, activate your glutes a little bit. So you're pushing your hips up, for me that works. Or maybe just see if you can lengthen that knee a little bit further to the front of the mat. Good. Breathing into that stretch. Take an inhale as you exhale, release. Inhale, place both feet back to the floor with the knees bent. Just untangle the legs. Then on the next inhale, reach through with your right hand, grab hold of your left foot, drop the left knee to the floor, to the front of the mat. Take your left arm up and over, drop it behind you to the floor, and then extend that right leg along the floor. Good, nice long reach from the knee all the way up to your fingertips. Breathe into that stretch. Take it inhale. As you exhale, release that foot. Take both feet back to the floor with the knees bent. On the inhale, take the knees into the chest, hands behind the knees, and a little rock up to seated. Come to a cross leg seating position, sitting up nice and tall. Relax the hands to the knees, close the eyes. Relax the shoulders. Draw the crown of the head up towards the sky. And we will set our intention for today's practice, which is, I am worthy. I am worthy of all the good things that come my way. Repeat that a couple of times in your mind. Let that sink in. I am worthy of all the good things that come my way. And let that intention go, focusing back in on your breath. So we're looking for a slow and steady breath throughout our practice. Deep breath in, long breath out. Picking up that rhythm of breathing, letting that breath drop all the way down to your belly. Feel the expansion as you're breathing in and the contraction as you're breathing out. See if you can keep that focus throughout the practice today. On the next inhale, open the eyes, drop the hands either side of the hips, and a little flow from here. We're going to inhale, hands reach up, palms together, exhale, twist to the left, hands drop down to the floor, take the gaze over your left shoulder. Inhale, reach up to the sky. Exhale, twist to the right. Hands drop all the way down, looking over your right shoulder. Good. Inhale, reach up. Exhale, twist to the left. Inhale, reach up to the sky. Exhale, twist to the right. Inhale, lift up to center. Exhale, twist to the left. Connect the movement with the breath. Inhale, reach up, slow breath in. Exhale, twist round to the right, slow breath out. Inhale, reach it up to the sky. Exhale, twist to the left. Reach the fingertips, touch them down to the earth. Inhale, back to center. Exhale, twist to the right. Fingertips all the way down and reach down towards the earth. Inhale, back to center. Exhale, twist to the left. Take your gaze all the way around if you can. Inhale, center. Exhale, twist to the right. Gaze all the way around over your shoulder. Good. Inhale, back to center. Exhale, twist to the left. And this time we're going to hold it there. Drop the back fingertips to the floor. Right hand behind your left knee. Keep coming round, taking your gaze over your left shoulder. Try and relax the knees, but reaching up nice and tall through your spine, crown, reaches all the way up to the sky. Inhale, come back to center. Exhale, twist to the right. Right fingertips drop behind, left hand behind your right knee. Coming all the way around, drawing the gaze over your right shoulder. Breathe in, create that space, and then as you breathe out, move into that space. Come round into that twist. Inhale, and then as you exhale, come back to center. We're going to roll over onto all fours. Come back a little bit on the mat if you need to. And then when you're ready, tucking the toes under, lift the seat up and back into downward facing dog. Hips nice and high, hips reach to the back of the mat. Relax the heels down towards the earth. Doesn't matter if they don't reach all the way down. Think nice long spine. Take a little walk from side to side. Extend one leg, bend the opposite knee, switch around. Maybe connect that movement with the breath. Inhaling, go one way, exhaling, go the other. Just taking the slow stretch through the back of each leg, maybe into the calves. Nice and easy. Good. And then coming to center. So from here we're going to do a little flow. We've done it quite a few times. We're going to do the first one slow, just to make sure your hands and feet are in the right place, and then connect the movement with the breath. You're going to inhale forward into plank, and hold it there, and adjust the hands so that the wrists are underneath the shoulders, and the heels are lengthening to the back of the mat, and you're nice and long, long shape, so crown of head all the way down to the heels. Good, take an inhale, and then as you exhale, you're going to slowly release to the floor. The elbows come back, and the whole of the body touches down in one go. On the inhale, lift into Cobra, so press down into the earth, lift your heart. Exhale, tuck the toes, lift the seat up and back into downward facing dog, leaving the hands and feet exactly where they were. So now we're going to flow with the breath. Connect the movement. Inhale forward into plank. Exhale slowly, lower down to the floor, slow and steady. Inhale cobra. Exhale downward dog. Good. Inhaling forward into plank. Exhaling slowly all the way down. Take the whole of that breath. Inhale into cobra. Lift your heart. Exhale downward facing dog. Good. Inhale slowly forward. Take the whole length of that breath. Exhale slowly down to the floor. Inhale into cobra. Exhale downward facing dog. One more round. Inhale forward into plank. Nice and steady as you exhale slowly down to the earth. Lovely. Really nice. Inhale cobra. Exhale downward facing dog. Take a breath here. Really lovely, guys. Nice and steady movements. Really smooth. Take an inhale. And then exhale, release the knees to the floor. Take the knees to the edges of the mat. And sit back to your heels, coming into a wide knee child pose. Breathing in, and then walking the hands out in front. As you breathe out, drop the chest down to the floor. Forehead all the way down. If you need to use the forearms to support the forehead, please do, or one of the blocks that you have. That works as well. Slow and steady breath. Fill that belly with the breath. Create that space. Breathing in to all the nooks and crannies, into all the corners of the body. And then when you're breathing out, allow the whole body to surrender down into the mat. Perfect. On the next inhale, lift your gaze. Come back up onto all fours. Tucking the toes. So come back up into downward facing dog. Good. Take a breath. So we're going to do that flow again, but instead of doing cobra, I'd like you to try and use up dog. So we're going to lift. So we're going to do the first one slow again, and then just make sure your hands and feet are in the right place, and then we connect the movement with the breath. Inhale forward into plank. Adjust your hands and feet as necessary. And then a slow exhale all the way down, elbows come back. Inhale, lift into up dog. So you lengthen the toes and the both legs come off the floor. Good. And then exhale back into downward facing dog. So we'll connect the movement with the breath. Nice and steady. Inhale forward into plank. Exhale, slowly release down. Inhale into up dog. Lengthen the toes, come up. Good. Exhale, downward facing dog. Inhale, forward into plank. Exhale, slowly all the way down to the floor. Inhale, up dog, lengthen the toes, lift the whole of the body up, and then exhale, downward facing dog. One more round. Inhale, forward into plank. Exhale, slowly all the way down. Inhale into up dog. Exhale, downward facing dog. Hold it there. Take a breath. Lovely. Very nice. Take an inhale and then exhale, release the knees to the floor. This time keep the knees together. Sitting back to your heels. Exhale, the whole of the upper body releases down into your thighs. If you want to, you can reach the arms out in front. Stretching into the arms and into the shoulders, releasing the forehead down to the ground. Good. Breathe into all those spaces into your body. Breathe out. Surrender into that pose. So we're going to do that flow one more time in a moment. And this time we're going to come into up dog, but instead of dropping all the way down to the floor, I want you to see if you can hover, lengthen the toes and come straight into up dog. So I'll talk you through it. On the next inhale, lift your gaze, come back up onto all fours. Tucking the toes under, lift the seat up and back into downward facing dog. Take a breath here. You're going to inhale forward, so we'll do one slow one round. Inhale forward, adjust the feet and hands so they're in the right position. When you exhale, I want you to drop down, but don't touch down all the way. So take an inhale, exhale, almost down, all the way. Lengthen the toes, and then inhale straight into up dog, if you can. Exhale, downward facing dog. So see, if that's too much, drop down to the floor. That's absolutely fine. Okay, inhale forward into plank. Exhale slowly, almost all the way down. Inhale straight into up dog. Exhale, downward facing dog. Good, lovely. Inhale, forward into plank. Exhale, slowly release, not touching down. Inhale, up dog. Exhale, downward facing dog. Lovely. Inhale, forward into plank. Exhale, slowly release, hover above the floor. Inhale, into up dog. Exhale, downward facing dog. One more round. Inhale, forward into plank. Exhale, slowly down to the floor. When you're ready, inhaling into up dog. Exhaling, downward facing dog. Hold it there. Lovely. Very nice. Catch your breath. Take a deep breath in through the nose. And then a big breath out through the mouth. Good. Take an inhale. And then exhale, release the knees to the floor. Take it back to child's pose. Sit back to your heels. Chest comes to your thighs. This time, take the arms through. If that feels comfortable, release the forehead all the way down to the floor. Use a block if you need to rest the forehead there. And then if you have taken the arms through, relax the shoulders, relax the upper body. Try and let go. This is your moment to rest, reset. It's your moment to let go of that last flow. Well done, really nice everyone. Good, on the next inhale lift your gaze, come back up onto all fours, remove the block if you have it there, coming into our cat and cow. Knees are hip width apart, wrists are underneath the shoulders. On the inhale, lift the tailbone, drop the belly down and lift your gaze. Exhaling, rounding through that spine, push away from the floor. Release the head, look through to your feet. Inhale, lift that tailbone, relax the belly, lift your gaze. Exhale, round through that spine, lift that belly up to the sky. Tailbone drops down, look through to your feet. Inhale, lift. So continue in your own time, more importantly, continue connecting to your own breath. Good. On the inhale, you're lifting that gaze, you lift the whole of that heart, look forward. When you're exhaling, you're rounding through that spine, lifting that belly button up to the ceiling. Good. Inhale, lift it forward, lift up. And exhaling, rounding through that spine. Perfect. Very nice. Inhale forward one more time. And then on the exhale, come to a neutral spine. From here, we're going to thread the needle. Inhale, right fingertips up to the sky. Exhale, reach underneath, place your shoulder to the floor. Right cheek down to the mat. Left hand either on top of your right hand, or if you prefer, reach it behind your waist. Or you can leave that right, that left hand pressing down into the floor. Any of those options are good. Everyone's shoulders are a little bit different. Choose an option that gets you the best stretch out of that shoulder. Breathe into that stretch. Sometimes when we forget that static, that steady breathing when we're in a static pose, but it continue with that nice deep breath in, long breath out. It doesn't stop. Good. On the next inhale, slowly, if your left hand isn't on the floor, put it back and then press it up onto all fours. Just take a breath here to reset, and then we'll come and do the other side. Inhale, left fingertips reach up to the sky. Exhale, reach under, place the left shoulder to the floor, left cheek down, right hand either to the floor, top of the other palm, or reaching behind your waist. Good. Breathing into that shoulder, into that stretch. When you're ready, if your right hand is not on the floor, push it back, place it back onto the floor, and then push it up onto all fours, nice and slowly. Good. Tucking the toes under, lift the seat up and back into downward facing dog. Just take a breath here. Release the heels. On the next inhale, slowly walk the hands back towards your feet, bending into the knees as you do so. Let the whole of that spine be nice and long, dropping the head down towards the earth. Hands are resting onto the floor. So a nice deep bend into the knees. Perfect. And then when you're ready, engage in your core. Slowly start rolling up that spine. And coming all the way up to standing. Perfect. Come to the front of the mat, take the feet together, stand tall in Tadasana. Fingertips reach down to the earth, drawing the energy up through both legs, so you're activating both legs, engage those muscles. Belly button draws back to spine, chin is parallel to the floor and the eyes are closed. Tadasana, mountain pose. moment or two to tune into your breath. A moment to feel the feet on the mat. Good. On the next inhale, open the eyes. Take the feet hip width apart. We're coming to a little flow. I'm going to come sideways. Inhale, reach the hands up to the sky. Exhale, reach the hands behind, interlace the hands, roll the shoulders towards each other, then lengthen through the arms. Inhale, lift your gaze. Exhale, fold forward, bending into the knees, bringing the arms up and over, and as you do so, straighten through the legs, release the head. Inhale, bend into the knees, sweep up to the sky. Exhale, reach behind, interlace the hands, lengthen through the arms, inhale, lift your heart, exhale, fold forward, bringing the arms up and over, release the head, lengthen through the legs, inhale, bend into the knees, sweep up to the sky, exhale, reach behind, interlace your hands, lengthen, reach the hands down, inhale, lift, exhale, fold forward, all the way down, lengthen through the legs as you come up and over, inhale, bend into the knees, reach up to the sky, exhale, reach behind, interlace your hands. Inhale, lift your heart. Exhale, fold forward, hands. So it comes up and over, lengthen through the legs. Inhale, bend into the knees, lift up to the sky. Exhale, reach behind, interlace your hands. Lengthen through the arms, inhale, lift. Exhale, fold forward, bend into the knees, then lengthen, arms up and over. Inhale, bend into the knees, lift up to the sky. And then exhale, release the hands back to Tadasana, to the side of the hips. Bring the feet back together. From here, we're going to do a chair flow. Just getting the body moving, connecting movement and breath. Inhale into high chair. Exhale into low chair. Inhale, hands to heart center. Exhale, twist to the left, both elbows to the outside of that knee. Rotate that ribcage all the way round. Good. Inhale back to heart center. Exhale, twist round to the right. Take your ribcage all the way round and look to the right. Good. Inhale to heart center. Exhale, forward fold, lengthen through the legs, release the head, long spine. Inhale, halfway up, hands to shins, look up. Exhale, forward fold, long legs. Inhale into high chair. Exhale, back to Tadasana. And again, inhale, high chair, bend the knees, lift the arms. Exhale, low chair, bend into the knees, arms come out in front. Inhale, heart center. Exhale, twist to the left, all the way around. Good. Inhale, heart center. Exhale, twist to the right. Inhale, heart center. Exhale, forward fold, lengthen through the legs, and then release the head and spine to the earth. Inhale, halfway up, hands to shins, look up. Exhale, forward fold. Inhale, high chair, bend the knees, lift the arms. Exhale, back to Tadasana, one more round. Inhale, high chair. Exhale, low chair, bend all the way down into the knees, good. Inhale, heart center. Exhale, twist to the left. Rotate that ribcage all the way around. Inhale, heart center. Exhale, twist round to the right. Use the elbow for leverage if you need to. Inhale, heart center. Exhale, forward fold. Lengthen through the legs, release the head. Inhale, halfway up, hands to shins, look up. Exhale, forward fold. Inhale, high chair. Bend the knees and lift the arms. And exhale, back to Tadasana. Good. Take a moment in Tadasana. Let that breath settle down again. And then, if you've got your blocks around you, just grab hold of the blocks. Put them in front of you. And we're going to come into Parsvottanasana, which is where we step back with the right foot. You step on the inhale, step back up with the right foot. I haven't got the two blocks, which I should have, but they're inside. And then just make sure that the back heel is dropping down into the mat. Both legs stay straight. Take an inhale. Exhale, fold forward. Chest comes down towards your thigh. And then use your blocks. So you might want to have them upright. and use your blocks to release the hands down onto the blocks. So you can adjust the blocks to where it feels okay for you and you get the most out of that stretch through the back of the legs. I'd like you to see if you can keep both legs straight, and I'd like you to see if you can keep that back heel firmly pressing down into the mat. Good. Hold it there. Breathe into that stretch. Press the hands down equally as you're pressing both feet down into the mat. Take an inhale, as you exhale, release the hands to the waist. Inhale, lift it all the way up. And exhale, step it back to Tadasana. Inhale, step it back with the left foot. Drop that heel into the floor. Both legs straight, hips facing to the front of the mat. Take an inhale. Exhale, fold forward. Allow that chest to drop to your thigh. Take the hands to the blocks. Adjust the blocks. If they're high, that's absolutely fine. I want to take the focus to the stretch through the back of that front leg. So if the blocks are high, that's absolutely fine. Quite a strong stretch? Yeah. So you might find it's quite a strong stretch, so I'm expecting the blocks to be higher rather than lower. Breathe into the back of that leg. Breathe into that stretch. Slowly, on the exhale then, allow that upper body to relax forward. Just gently pressing the hands into the blocks and releasing that back heel into the floor. Good, hold it there. On the inhale, take an inhale, so exhale, take the hands to the hips. Inhale, lift it all the way up to the sky. Good. Exhale, back to Tadasana. Well done. Take the blocks to one side. And we're just going to do a little, so we're not doing so much standing today. We're going to take a little vinyasa down to the floor. Inhale, reach the hands up to the sky. Exhale, forward fold. Long legs, head releases. Inhale, halfway up. Exhale, step it back to plank, right foot, left foot. Slowly down to the floor. Inhale into Cobra or Up Dog. Exhale, Downward Facing Dog. Good. Hold it there, just a breath. And then on the next inhale, take one shin forward, take the other one behind, and take it through to seated. And do a little flow between boat and plank. Find your sitting bones, and on the inhale, lift the feet off, either the shins are parallel to the floor, hands can be behind the knees, or they can be parallel along the legs. The legs can also be straight. Lift your gaze to your toes, adjust to whatever variation works for you. Lifting that heart up towards your thighs, so nice and tall through the upper body. Breathe. Hold it there, keep breathing, lifting up. Good. On the next inhale, cross the shins, draw the feet in towards you, drop them down to the floor, and then roll over and step it back to plank and hold it there. Just a normal plank, wrists are underneath the shoulders, heels are lengthening to the back of the mat, crown reaches to the front of the mat. Nice and steady. Belly button comes back to spine. Good, lovely. Take an inhale, rock slowly forward onto your toes. Exhale, slowly drop it down to the floor. Inhale, lift into Cobra or Up Dog. Exhale, downward facing dog. Good. On the next inhale, take one shin forward, take the other one behind, take it through to seated. Feet in front. Inhale, back to boat. Lift the feet. Shins are either parallel to the floor or both legs are extended up to the sky. Option is all yours. Breathe and lift. Inhale, crown reaches up, chest comes towards your thighs. And then just slowly exhale. Perfect. Hold. Good. Inhale, cross the shins, draw the feet in, drop them down to the floor. Roll it over into plank, step it back to plank. On the next inhale, we're going to come into a side plank. Shift your weight over to the left. Right foot stacks on top of left foot. Right fingertips reach up to the sky. If that's too much, you can step forward with the right foot, the top leg, to support. Or you can drop the knees to the floor and take the feet behind. So either option is good. Adjust it to what feels okay. Take an inhale, come back to center, drop that right hand back to the floor. Exhale here, inhale, lengthen, shift forward onto the toes. Exhale, slowly drop it down to the floor. Inhale, lift into Cobra. Exhale, downward facing dog. Take a breath. Inhale, forward with your right shin. Take the other one behind. Take it through to seated. One more round. Inhale, back into boat. Choose your option. Lifting the feet off the floor, shins parallel, or both legs extended. Use your core, engage that core to draw your chest a little bit closer to your thighs. Crown reaches up to the sky. Gaze to your big toes. Take an inhale, cross the shins, draw the feet in, drop them down to the mat, roll it over, step it back into plank. When you're ready, we come to plank on our right side. Shift the weight over to your right, left foot on top of your right foot, left fingertips reach up to the sky. If that's too much, step it forward with the top leg halfway up the mat. You can support your side plank in that way. Or you can drop both knees to the floor and support it that way. Either option is good. Hold it there. Pressing that hand down into the floor and lift away. Good. Inhale, come back to centre. Drop that left hand back to the floor. Take a breath here. On the inhale, shift forward onto your toes. Exhale, slowly release to the floor. Inhale, lift into Cobra. Exhale, downward facing dog. Hold it there, take a breath. Good. Take an inhale, then exhale, release the knees to the floor. And then rub it all the way down onto your front. Inhale, take the elbows forward, bring them underneath the shoulder, come into Sphinx. Forearms and palms are pressing down into the mat, and you're lifting your heart and gaze is lifted as well. So you're looking forward, pressing down and away from the mat. Lift up from your elbows and your forearms into a little back bend.
Take an inhale, as you exhale, slowly release. Come into crocodile, stacking one forearm on top of the other, rest the forehead onto the forearms. Breathe into your belly. Let that belly press down into the floor. Maybe noticing that breath expand into the different parts of the body. Good. On the next inhale, lift your gaze. We're going to come into bow, bend both knees. Reach behind, grab hold of the ankles, if that feels okay. You need a hand?
Yeah, actually we do.
Then slowly on the inhale, lift the upper body up. Not quite, no. Just be mindful of your knees. If it's too much for your knees, just lift. Maybe more into Shavasana. That's it, lovely. And then, yes, that's it. Try and keep the knees together. Keep that chest nice and broad and lifted, looking forward. Breathe into your belly. I'd like to see a little bit of rocking as you're breathing. It means you're breathing down into your belly. Good. Perfect. Take one more breath. Exhale. Slowly release. Let go of the feet. Take the hands underneath the shoulders. Inhale, press it up onto all fours, and then exhale, take it back to child's pose. Just counterbalance, counter. Slowly take that roll through your spine. So you're going from one to the other. Just take a moment maybe to roll through that spine before you sit back to your heels. And then relax the chest onto your thighs. Okay? Breathe. Breathe into the tension. If there is any tension, breathe into that. Expand and release on the exhale. Good. On the next inhale, we'll lift your gaze, walk the hands back towards you, sit up onto your heels, swing the legs around to the front. Come to sit back into Sukhasana. Take the hands to the knees for a moment. If you need a block, just grab that, sit onto that. We're going to come into eagle arms. We're going to take our right elbow underneath the left. Wrapping the forearms around each other, bring the palms together. Maybe take this opportunity to close the eyes. And slowly lifting the elbows, if that feels okay, just adjust them up or down to a point where you can get into the stretch across the back of the shoulder blades in what feels good for you. Then take your focus to your breath. Breathing in, expanding into that stretch across the back. Breathing out and release. Take an inhale. On the exhale, slowly open up the arms. Drop the hands to the shoulders, to the knees for a moment. And then we'll come into a forward fold. Inhale, lift, lengthen. Exhale, big stretch. Reach right into the front of the mat. And then exhaling, release the upper body. Drop that heart down towards the floor. Into that forward fold. Try and think soft through the knees. Soft through the hips. Good. inhale, lift your gaze, walk the hands back towards you, sit up tall, switch the legs around, take the other leg in front, release the knees back to the earth, sit up tall, adjust, eagle arms the other side, taking your right elbow underneath your left elbow, wrapping the four, no, it's the other way around, sorry, left elbow underneath your right elbow, wrapping the forearms around, bringing the palms together. Take a moment to close the eyes. And then take a moment to adjust the elbows up or down to a position where you can get into that stretch in the most beneficial way. Then once you've done that, focus on the breath. Take an inhale, and then on the exhale, slowly unwrapping the arms. Drop the hands to the knees for a moment. Take an inhale, lift. Reaching forward, and as you exhale, slowly breathing out, releasing the whole of the upper body down towards the earth. Releasing into those hips as you come forward. Take an inhale, lift your gaze, walking the hands back towards you. Sit up tall. Take the hands underneath the knees, lift them up towards each other, stretch the legs out in front. Take an inhale, and on the exhale, we're going to slowly roll down onto our back. Then bend the knees and place the soles of the feet onto the mat. From here, we're going to come into a supine twist. Inhaling your right knee into the chest, stretch the left leg away, right arm out, shoulder height, palm facing up. And then exhale, draw that knee over to your left. Keep both shoulders firmly planted into the ground. Turn to gaze at the palm of your right hand. Allow that top leg to slowly release on each exhale. Comes a little bit heavier and a little bit heavier. Inhaling into that twist, exhaling, releasing that top leg. Good, hold it there. And then inhaling back to center. Exhale, both feet to the floor with the knees bent. Straighten yourself up, making the adjustments to come back to center. And then supine twist on the other side. Inhale, left knee into the chest, right leg stretches away to the floor. Left arm out shoulder height. And then exhale, draw that knee over to your right side. Doesn't have to come all the way over, just slowly take it over. Both shoulders are planted, dropping down into the floor, taking the gaze to the palm of your left hand, if that feels okay. Focusing on that breath, inhaling into your twist, exhaling. Each time you exhale, release that top leg, allow that to be a little bit heavier. A little bit more relaxed. Good. Inhaling, coming back to center. Exhale, drop both feet to the floor with the knees bent. Take the knees in towards each other and then the feet to the edges of the mat. Just for a few moments. We'll stay here while we just briefly come back to the intention we set earlier. Maybe you have the eyes closed already. If you haven't, time. Just start taking everything in, inwards. The intention we set earlier was I am worthy. I am worthy of all the good things that come my way. Repeat that a couple of times in your mind. I am worthy of all the good things that come my way. Let that intention go. And we'll just take a moment to focus back on the breath. And we'll just focus on it so that we can then actively release and let go. Allowing that breath to return to a softer breath, a more relaxed breath. Perfect. And then when you're ready, slowly make your way into Shavasana. Walk the feet out in front, stretch the legs away from you. Have the arms just a little bit away from the body and have the palms facing up to the sky. That gives your shoulders a little bit more space to relax into the ground. Think about lengthening from the crown of the head down to the toes. Lift the heels and stretch them away to the front of the mat and relax them down again afterwards. Take your chin and just a tiny little bit of drawing it down towards your chest to lengthen through the back of the neck. And then relax again, both shoulders to the floor. Good. Finding length and finding space, creating that space in the whole of the body. Relaxing both feet, the soles of the feet, the toes and the ankles. Releasing any tension in the calves, the shins, the hamstrings and the quads. Relaxing the whole of both of the legs. Relaxing the hips. Allow the belly to be soft, the rib cage is soft, shoulders are soft and heavy, dropping into the floor. Relaxing both along both arms, through to the elbows, down to the wrists, into the palms, and into your fingertips. Relaxing along the back of the neck, the back of the head resting onto the floor. Softening through your face, releasing any tension along your cheekbones, your jawline. Allow your lips to be soft. Allow your forehead to be smooth. Relaxing the whole of the body. From your toes all the way up to the crown of the head. Back a little bit of movement into your toes and into your fingers, give them a little wriggle, stretch into your hands and into your feet. And then we will bring a bit of life and a little bit of movement back to the body by taking a deep breath in through the nose and a big breath out through the mouth. Deep breath in. Big lazy breath out through the mouth. One more. Deep breath in. Big breath out through the mouth. On the next inhale, sweep the arms up behind you, bring the feet together, long stretch. And then as you breathe out, bring the arms up and over, knees into the chest, give yourself a hug, a little rock from side to side. Then when you're ready, keeping the knees tucked and the eyes closed, slowly roll it over to your right side. Allow the feet and the legs to drop down to the floor. Enjoy those last few moments. Good. When you're ready, place your left hand to the floor and then gently press yourself back up to a seated position, just nice and slowly. Once you're seated, cross legs or legs out in front. Bringing the palms together into Namaste, and then gently pressing the thumbs back into your chest. And we will close our practice with one round of Om. Taking a deep breath in. Wishing your peace in your thoughts, your words, your actions, and your heart. Om Shanti. Namaste. Thank you for your practice. Well done.
Thank you.
Lovely, lovely. Right. I'm going to just press that and hopefully I won't bugger it.